Special guest here from Germany, from Stuttgart, represent Daimler, Jan and Flado. Thank you very much for joining us this year. And we have again our beautiful ladies over here from Google Open Source Department. And the Google Cloud team, of course, but I guess nobody from Google Cloud is here now. Is there any? Andrew, yes, Andrew is here. Thank you, Andrew, for joining us. And Microsoft, anyone? Ben, thank you so much. And thank you for moderating the track as well. And Mario, you want to continue with the rest?
So you can have a break, right? Okay, good. So who else do we want? Let's scroll up a bit so we also show, give some credit here to all the supporters. Okay, so you find them on the website with links. So it's great that we also see like a lot of companies that actually make their income with open source. And we're glad this year that Nextcloud joined us, Frank, with a keynote. Also here, Frank, thanks a lot for joining us here this year and supporting. And it was a bit quiet for about OpenSUSE for a few years. They changed the ownership and so on. And we had a few years ago a lot of activity with Mike Veltman. I think he worked with OpenSUSE in Singapore. And now the community is getting started again. So thanks for joining us here and supporting the event. I think the guys are still, are you here somewhere? I can't see you. I think still down there. But thank you a lot, OpenSUSE. Okay. And let's put everyone else in one group, so don't spend too much time, because like we already know about the awesome work and support of the sponsors. So Intel visited us this year. They wanted to see how Force Asia going. They said they will see like how to join in future. Thanks, Intel, for joining. KI Group joined with a lot of good advice here and help us to get in touch with companies. Creditive is a big company famous for Debian. At one point, they had like the most Debian developers in one space in the world, like working for their company. Gandhi.net, support already also for the second year here. Thomas came from Taiwan all the way over. We have MBM, MySQL, they had a track here today, and Excel Tech, as well as we had the Postgres track. So thanks a lot to everyone who really like make this event possible. Thank you very much.
Nayana, can I have you up here, please? Do we have Kiwi in the room? No.
Still like setting up things. Okay.
Yeah. Yes, so what do we want to do here at the closing? We want to hear from you. So many things going on, so many talks, so many presentations, but we really do not have any time to interact with you. And this is the chance that you can come up and tell us what do you feel about the event and what do you want us to improve or do better, or any feedback, we're open for it. So please, we only have 20 minutes for the closing. Before we head upstairs for a lot of beers.
Okay, so maybe I want to outline a bit like who did what, because not everyone knows what's actually going on, and some people might see Dan here the first time and didn't even know that he was so active. So at Force Asia, we are like always a bit like world domination. Right, so we're always thinking about that, and somewhere in the sessions of the open event team here, which did fantastic work, a lot of guys from India also came over, and also of course like through the support of Google Summer of Code, we like made a big jump in this project, and now it's like rising all the time. So why open event? We now have our own system for ticketing. Tesla coil, okay. We have our own system for ticketing, for making events possible, which all of you can use, you can set it up. So this is awesome. We made it happen. I know there are a lot of bugs, yeah, but we made it happen. So this is the first thing. The next thing is we decided, okay, let's set up our own open source network. Yeah, I mean, like, let's not take any provider or something. Let's get our own gear or work with companies together. And Roland, Dan, how long did we actually spend? When did we start?
Weeks ago.
Months ago, this has been a sort of ongoing discussion and negotiation with multiple parties over at least the last 6 weeks. We finally settled on borrowing a bunch of equipment from Allagas, which is why their name appears in the name of the network. In fact, they were not that fussed about being credited. All they wanted was the performance data, because this is an unusual venue and an unusual event. So they wanted a sense of what their equipment does under load. The feedback I've had from engineers.sg, who are perhaps the heaviest users of our network, single group, it's Michael and friends, is they've been uploading videos right through the event without missing a beat. And so I, compared to last year, it's been a massive improvement. The guts of the work was Wednesday, Thursday, and to some extent Friday, quite late at night, because we can't drag ladders around in the middle of the science center when it's full of the public. So Dan and myself and Marco and Andrew and Matthew, who are currently ripping the network apart, and one other person, I forget who.
And Zygus,
thank you. We're here late Wednesday and Thursday night, putting up cables and access points to make sure the whole thing came together. So it's been there will be a blog post. We took a few photos. Mario's asked for this, but it's a fascinating experience to actually build the network for real. Thank you, Tesla. For an event where, like, everyone has mobiles and notebooks on the network in use the whole time. So
certainly there were some challenges with various things not working out, but there were always plan Bs and plan Zs.
Just to be clear, we had two telco circuits, one of which mysteriously stopped working at 4 p.m. on Thursday afternoon. We lost half our network capacity, and so some of the cabling was rerouting around that. So we had the contingencies planned, and we got to use them, but it was a bigger task than expected.
Yeah.
So this about the network, and I think it's one of the few events of this size that where actually the community sets up their own network. And I would like to thank you especially for making this happen. And I know how much work it is. So thank you a lot. Like, we have Dan. Yeah. Okay. Thank you a lot. So Daniel Blumen and Roland Turner, who led this initiative, and as they mentioned, like, a lot of support and help from the team. Who else do we have, Funk?
We have Nayana here.
So Nayana.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
I don't know what to tell, but I'm so happy. This is my first time joining the team. End of the wall. People here, they enjoy. They participate a lot of talks and sharing, get to know more people. It feels so happy end of that. Yeah, thank you all for being here. Yeah.
Okay, so and we have also designers who helped us to make this happen. Roger, where are you? Ah, okay, there behind Roger, who did, for example, these cool badges that we all have, yeah, and a lot of other things, so thanks, Roger, yeah. And actually, at different points, it's all a community effort, so there were always, things to do, and then, of course, everyone has a job, and we had, other things to do, like a poster and so on. And it's amazing, if you call out in the open source community, people just start to help. And actually a lot of thanks also to Victoria, hey, yes. So thank you. So there is the opensourcedesign.net website where Victoria, she's running it with Jan together also, and others from Tesla Coil, from Nextcloud also, right, Jan? And you just called out also for help from people, and actually another Russian girl who's also called Victoria then from Seoul helped us actually and made this cool hat, yeah, that we saw. So this is also a big community effort, and we have a lot of ideas how to improve on that. We already have started a software project, a badge maker, yeah, to make open source badges, click and they will generate them for you. So that's pretty cool. Then of course we have Michael here, who is always a very serious face, but yeah, who's helping us, like from Engineers SG. There are actually a number of people from Engineers SG. I think we should like give you guys credit. We will list you on the website and everything. Like also.
And your video of day one and day two are ready on the website, ready on our YouTube.
So this is all already fantastic. It looks like a number get like already quite a few clicks, yeah? And so people can actually join the event now more and more online as well. Yeah,
and we are also trending Twitter the last 2 days.
Yeah, Force Asia was trending on Twitter here for the first time, so quite nice. I don't know, does it speak for Force Asia? I think so, right? I mean, we had over a few hundred thousand hits over the last 2 days on the Twitter account, and yeah, that was cool. Thank you. So I think, like, we didn't give everyone credit. Like, I see a lot of people in the room always helping. Like, I see, like, somebody who's very tired because they also helped us with design, Valentine, right? And a lot of other people. I think, like, we should thank everyone. Just give a clap to everyone, maybe. And one more thing, of course, like whenever you had a problem, like you needed a plug or something, there was always one person here, our pilot trainer, who is probably working out some electrical issues now, still in the exhibition hall. Very strong guy, right? You probably know who I'm talking about, Kiwi, right? Okay, so. So sure, we thank everyone, but we would like to know, what do people think about the event? So do we want to give out the microphone and just like get some feedback, see how we can do?
I'm starting to take that personally. Comments here?
See ya.
Frank.
First of all, I wanted to say like a big thank you to the team again. I think it's such a perfect and wonderful conference. It's really, I said it like to you earlier, I think it's just perfectly organized. Everything worked. Everything worked. That's really, really amazing. So big thank you to all the volunteers again. Of course, I also have like a tiny suggestion for improvement. So so to upload my slides, I had to reactivate a very old Dropbox account of mine. So maybe in the future.
Okay, that's really awesome suggestion. So we're looking for your extended sponsorship next year because.
Somebody else has taken me to task at some length over that fact. So yes.
I think you were starting at like 1,500 per month, right? So that's pretty cool. So thanks a lot for coming on board with that.
No other feedback? Yep.
Again, thank you to the whole team, but I especially want to call out Hong Phuc and Mario. They are the reason that this whole program works, and they are always there with a smile on their face. They seem to be in every, you turn around and there they are. They're wherever you need them, and I just want to say thank you. It's always a pleasure to be able to see you. We wish you got to see you more often, and you're always welcome to come see us in San Francisco, so please come stop by.
Nobody else? Stunned silence.
So that is a good sign.
Where?
We don't have any negative feedback. Thank you very much.
There is the one there.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if you chose this venue on purpose because it was like a science park, but at least for me, it was like quite enjoyable, like having all those gadgets around. And maybe you could organize something like to explore if you choose this venue next year again, like have a session specifically for it or something, because it was a bit like running from one talk to another and then like, oh damn, this is so cool, I want to try it, you know, and then you didn't have the time and then you have to run. I will come later, you know, but I'm based here in Singapore at least for a while, so but many other people maybe they would have liked to kind of take the opportunity of the trip to play with it.
Okay. Yeah, so for example, so I'm German, but I don't know, by chance quite a few people are German. Like I'm talking to this company from Taiwan and they're sending over a German. I don't know, yeah? I mean, that's happening here, but like in Germany we have a few hacker events and so on. So for example, the Chaos Communication Congress, and so we like it, yeah? That people can even stay overnight. And we run Force Asia at different spaces. We run it at universities. We also run it at Block 71 and Block 79 here in Singapore, right? Before, like, so more like a startup-focused event. And then Hong Phuc actually met Kirutika, right? Dr. Kirutika here. Are you here? I didn't see Kiru here yet, right? She's...
No,
probably still out. And they came on board, and we loved this space because, like, a lot of open source projects come out of like a playful situation, yeah, or like people have this kind of ideas, and it just seemed like this is the right place to be. And we even expand on this, yeah. So we're talking about having the whole space next year, because still like there were a few other things like going on, which sometimes distracting, and really like have this like a creation space, and the Science Center from there, they even said, oh, let's even explore if people can stay the whole night. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't have dared, because we are in Singapore and like it's more conservative here, and like, you know, they're opening hours, closing hours, you know, like, but like, yeah, I mean, cool, they already have this idea, so we're exploring more what we can do. But we're in Asia, so and Asia always means for me like make a living. I come from Berlin, and a lot of people like in the 90s, they used to be just play around, and it's not so important to actually make an income. Yeah, at that time, but things have changed, and we also learned here in Asia that it's important that when students or somebody goes home at night, their parents will ask, how can you earn an income? So for us, I think it's important that Force Asia is also a kind of incubator for this kind of thing, so that people don't have to move on to, like, let's say, a closed source proprietary project or something like that, so they can earn income. So next year we want to expand on the exhibition and offer also, like, for example, Michael was here, Meskis with Creative. They're very interested actually to expand with this idea. So that would be an idea. So expanding in both ideas and just see where it goes. Yeah, and we also have questions like from the Hong Kong folks. I think they had to leave already. They want to run an event. Ah, yeah, Hagen, right? And Hagen yesterday asked me, hey, if we do it in Hong Kong or if we do it in China, and then somebody else will copy that event and they will do it as well. And then what do we do? I say, well, yes, that's what we want. Let them copy that, right? I mean, like, or what if they don't do it the same way? Well, I think then people won't go there anymore. They don't like it, yeah? Or if they do it better, then let's go all there, right? I mean, we don't care. We want to develop all this cool stuff that we are doing, and whatever is the best fit for us, we will do it. So if you like this fit, then let's continue. Yeah, the Science Center is dedicated to continue with us, but like, let's also improve like on like the whole surrounding. So yeah, is that kind of an answer also to your question? Yeah. So yeah. Okay. So yeah, let's do it, and let's see how we can do more, and let's set up our own Nextcloud instance next year. I just didn't want to do everything: develop a software, set up Nextcloud, make our own network. What else? Yeah, I mean, like run the AC system. I don't know. Yeah. So there are a lot of things that we can do.
we had some interest. Harish and myself had talked about supporting and using Serval. Not so much as a freedom-preserving thing, but as a sort of the ability for apps to run completely independently. These are apps that run phone-to-phone. So two things happened. One was that, was the, oh my God, the list is already too long. And the other is, we learned many things about Wi-Fi, or I did. One of them is it's really hard to do that sort of stuff on a managed network. But we are not completely deterred. We want to make it work. So I very much reached the, we failed this year, but with that sort of stuff, it's not just a, oh, that's a good idea. There was actual work on this in the last 6 weeks, where we finally ran into, we haven't got time to finish, but would like to be able to support that sort of stuff on the network next year. So, yes. I have the same problem. This is the second year I've been sort of doing this, and I found two new halls that I've never seen before, like yesterday. If we don't run a cable through it or hold a session in it, I don't know it exists. So I took some time yesterday to actually go and look at the sort of marine life exhibit. But, you know, there's so much to do. You had a...
I also like the venue very much, so I just want to continue on that. So that's also the reason, because the timings, I mean, 9 o'clock in the morning, that's really not any kind of hacker timing at all. And being finished at 5 o'clock, I mean, you just mentioned the CCC, so we don't start before noon early. So that's also because of the venue, I guess, because they close down at 6 or something. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, that's part of the reason. And another reason is we're still trying to figure out when actually a lot of people come and what times. So we don't have such a good... We don't track everyone, yeah, yeah. All the time. So it's sometimes hard to know because in Asia the times are sometimes different, yeah? People they get up very early in the morning and then it's too hot during the day, so there's less activity. So yeah. We're still trying to figure out. So if you have any feedback on that, how we can do it better, yeah, sure.
Yeah, and I also would love to have like a tour through the house in like from a FOSS Asia perspective. I think that's a really, really good idea. And I want to underline this, not only the Dropbox, but also the Slack and the Meetup and the Google Group. So whatever message you send to me as a speaker, I was always replying, oh, I'm very sorry, but I won't join this. So is there any way I can get like information on another way? So it was all like the full communication. I was actually sitting in this IRC channel for months just alone, so yeah. Please come by.
Actually, we have, if you don't know that, we have speakers, docforceasia.org, with all the information for speakers at that event. I mean, we've been working on it over the last few years, so every year we improve and we try to put all the information in one place. So if you haven't, nobody's yet, yeah. Yes, you don't speak.
It's also the chat systems, so the fact that we're using WhatsApp.
So it depends. Like I'm fully for open source, but the question where you draw the line. So I think we draw the line for what we can do and what we can arrange. So there are other conferences, they try to do everything, but it's sometimes then difficult actually to get the slides. Yeah. I'm not so much on Slack, for example. We just like. People say they want to use the tool and we want to enable people to communicate. We don't want to stop them. So other people can go on Jitter or Gitter. How is it? Yeah, like
Gitter,
it's also closed source. Maybe they will, now it's GitLab, maybe they will open source it. Yeah, but my personal thing is like always like, I don't know if we want to get into this discussion now because it can be a very deep discussion. We have the German word of Datensparsamkeit, yeah, saving data. And the question is if we should agree because maybe we should set up services to collect data ourselves. Because like it's not so much only about do you have the open source solution, but do you actually have the data? We all have the open source solution. We can run Linux. We can program all these web services. Yeah. So that's a whole different discussion. And just because you have this feeling, it doesn't mean everyone agrees. Because we want to mainly run an event, and we do it as best as we can with the open source solutions. But like we can't distance ourselves completely from the world and run it completely autark. Is that an English word? Yeah, autark.
Autark.
So completely like separated from what's going on. So we already try our best. So it would be great to get you on board. And
we are definitely
I'm sure
looking
you have time.
We're definitely looking.
Oh yeah.
It's not about giving the next load, and somebody has to maintain it. So
that's okay. Yeah. I have a question sort of for the room before I take Harish's, and it was on the unconference track, which seemed to get sort of limited love. Do people have thoughts about having an unconference track, wanting to do it, not wanting to do it, wanting to promote it differently? Do people even know we had one? Okay, not getting what an unconference is, fair enough, that has to be explained. You had a same? Okay.
I just think it's weird having an unconference track in a conference.
It's
unconferences,
how we do an unconference in a 13-track conference is, yeah, that might be the tricky bit. Was there one of it there somewhere? No? So.
Well, indeed, it was hard to complete conference and unconference. At the same time, you need to choose one, you don't know what's going to happen there. So one would be.
life is like a box of chocolates. You don't know what you're going to get. All right. I'm sort of hearing the same things I'm hearing from Informway, so okay. Thank you. Harish.
So I just wanted to record my thanks to the team. It's always fun to have this happen over and over again. Clearly, there's a lot more things that needs to be done. One of the suggestions that I may want to offer is the kind of infrastructure we have been putting in place bit by bit, you know, step by step. We may want to have a wish list of other things that we want to put in, so you know the community can work on trying to fill in the blanks over the next year. Hopefully, by the next time around, we have some of the other things that we want to make sure it works well as well. You know, things like the shared resources, calendaring, whatever it may be. But if you know that's our way of contributing to build up the entire ecosystem of everything that we need to do. So I just want to record that might be something that we may be able to put together a to-do list, a wish list of what can be done, what needs to be done, and people can pick it up and run with it and see what they can provide and bring to the table. So the next year, we address those things as well and future iterations of it as well. But finally, I just wanted to record my thanks again for all of you to come here to Singapore. It's always, to me, that's, as a Singaporean, that is a fantastic thing for me, all right, to see all of you come here, and we are moving forward. And I was very, very pleased on Friday when the CIO of the government CIO saying that open source is the way to do things. For the government of Singapore to say that, that to me is a big, big plus. So I would, if you can, clap loud enough so that the rest of the Singapore government can hear, that would be great. So if this has been recorded, I hope they will hear it. So tweet to GovTech, at GovTech. Okay, tweet to them saying they are doing a fantastic job making sure open source is being used in Singapore government. Because once that happens, there's a lot more things that we can also do. So thank you very much, guys, for making this happen.
Kiwi. that's a bigger deal than it sounds. Periodically, various Singapore government people sort of slag off open source as the cause of security problems. So I think the shift in the thinking is really important, and certainly having someone of that stature in public, in front of a free and open source software audience, making that argument is a really big piece of progress. Before I hand it back to Hong Phuc, I think a thanks is due to Harish as well. He's been a supporter from the outset. He made multiple introductions this year, one of which gave rise to the equipment for the Wi-Fi. So I couldn't have done by myself, so it's much appreciated. Thank you. Right. We'll certainly take technical questions. Yes. Yeah. If anyone has about anything, Wi-Fi certainly, but other things as well. Vishnu.
Yeah. As all are here, why don't we ask them what's the suitable time for starting up in the morning and ending? Yeah. Because next time we'll not.
Yeah. I have a confession. I didn't get into the conference this morning or yesterday or possibly even Friday before 10 a.m. So I was sitting in an Uber dealing with moderator queries. I don't know if anyone had realized this. Not in the Science Center. I was just sitting in a car doing stuff. 9 o'clock's too early for me. What? How do others feel? Is that a... And I know we have venue constraints, so this is more a sort of how the audience feels.
Kiro already said we can maybe do it overnight next year, so yeah, why not?
So let's probe this. Who is comfortable starting at 9 a.m.? Okay. 10 a.m.? Keep your hand up as we move forward. Right? 10 a.m., 11 a.m.? No, keep your hand up. Right, we're sort of moving the calendar forward, right? And midday? Right. Okay, now we take the hands down. Anyone who prefer to start sometime later than midday? Yes, but that's not how we're doing it, because you'll want to finish at 4 a.m.
How long in the evening?
Right, that's an interesting one, because, of course, if we're running that late, we then start getting into where we crash. In terms of a scheduled finish, let alone whether we actually arrange overnight stays in the Science Centre. 6 p.m., 7 p.m., 8 p.m.
Although also though linked to that, what about session length? Perhaps sessions that are shorter, slightly.
We already use a range all the way from 20 minutes to like 2 or 3 hours, depending on what the
multi-hour content. Sessions though might be a little bit long. So, yeah.
But they're usually that's a.
It's usually a workshop.
It's a workshop or something of that kind. Where was I? Closing times. So 6 p.m. got no takers. That's great. 7 p.m. 8 p.m., 9 p.m., oh my God, 10 p.m., 11 p.m., midnight or later. Right, so it sounds like we're talking about roughly sort of 11 a.m. to about 10 p.m. as a comfortable set of hours, depending upon what's possible with the venue. Cool. Do we want to talk about Kiwi's contribution now that he's here?
Yeah, Kiwi. Sure. So I'm a logistic man in a way. So just tell me how much beer you need. So enough beer or not? You need more?
I think we had enough last night.
Yeah, that's me. Okay. So I would like to hear from the guys from a logistics standpoint. Do you have any issues that you guys want to raise up so that we can do better next year? So logistics come from electrical support equipment to even your food. Beer and so on and so forth.
Carson?
The recording equipment for recording the video created some, let's say, glitches with laptops being able to display it all. I know my talk had a lot of trouble with it. My laptop, it worked perfectly on a VGA cable out straight to a projector. Going through the recording equipment for HDMI, it was basically spent like 15 minutes trying to get it to work. And I had a 20 minute slot.
Okay, so.
And I saw another person have the same or similar problems as well.
We'll take.
Okay, guys, if let's say you guys face a similar problem, can you just raise up your hand so we know that it's consistent?
Whoa, sorry, this is specifically with plugging laptops into the recording equipment rather than directly into projectors.
Yeah.
Yep. So the other question then is plugging into projectors without recording equipment, okay, get it. So we've got half a dozen of each.
Okay. So, but the question here would be, what operating system you are running, or like, yeah, it's quite a specific question. I mean, how to solve this issue? Just by raising the issue, we don't solve it. Like, are you all guys running a Mac, or is it like the equipment?
No, it's the equipment.
Do we have to change the firmware? Yeah, I mean, oh, what? What's the solution?
There's a capture device in here, and it's a
exactly.
We need to explore its VGA handling capabilities, as we still have people with VGAs. Laptop output. So fair enough.
So, okay.
I think that's an action item to pursue, and if we need to help you guys with our equipment.
Hi, Heidi. Michael here. I run Engineers at SG. Hi, my name is Michael. I run Engineers at SG. I get the problem that you have. I apologize. For the problems that you have. This year we did try a different configuration because we understand all the rooms had only VGA. So we tried a technical solution, which is to use the laptop, our recording laptop, as a conduit to project whatever you guys are projecting. The reason we did this was last year we had issues with untrained volunteers operating our system. So we needed we wanted to be sure that we had idiot-proof card system. But as it turns out, it does cause some issues with your images being whited out or washed out and being unusable, basically laggy. So I...
those were the problems. I literally had things like the pixels were garbage.
Right.
Lots of pixels were garbage.
I see. Sure. Was your talk on the first day or second day?
Yesterday.
I see. Okay. No worry. Okay, I understand. Oh. Which room was this in? Which room were you in?
It'll be in the schedule.
Faraday? Okay. So in the Faraday room, we also had a technical issue with the laptop that we're using. We had replaced that laptop today. So I apologize that we couldn't fix that problem earlier. We try our best. Our team is really stretched. We have like five tracks going at the same time. So it was six. So yeah. Yeah.
Next year, look for it. If you can find a solution which is not going to do that, it's really going to work for Samsung because he works at Samsung.
Yeah. So.
Do you work for Samsung?
We would appreciate some nice laptops.
We'll take the action.
Thank you.
That's an ongoing bugbear, and it's one we would like to make work as smoothly as possible, and especially for both the recorded and unrecorded sessions, because it's a permanent problem. So, understood. So,
yeah, I just had another suggestion. Go
ahead. Go ahead.
Somebody pointed out that we need more software or services, so we don't have to use this proprietary stuff. Maybe we could have a hackathon times where we, or not a competitive hackathon, but where we actually do some practical coding to actually advance open source projects. That might be an interesting thing to do.
I'd be all for those sorts of hackathon or sprint or call it what you will. Our typical challenge and then sort of stepping into implementation detail, our typical challenge is that a large fraction of FOSS attendees, of course, don't live in Singapore or indeed in one place. And so those become slightly more difficult, but they're certainly worth doing. We will tackle the Nextcloud and independent system stuff earlier in the piece next year. If there is scope to run that, I think we'll propose it, because it's consistent with the stuff you're doing with GSFC and a bunch of other things, is to get this stuff built and running in ways that are useful for open tech conferences.
Yeah. So we have to see what we can bring together at one event. And we're always expanding, but the question is also, should we expand more, or more people? Sometimes possible, sometimes not. Yeah. And with a hackathon, you also need to focus on the hackathon. So maybe we could organize hackathon with this at FOSS Asia, but not at the summit, but maybe as we organize other events, also organize hackathons. One challenge, as Roland said, is if we do it in Europe, it's easy to go around. Nobody needs a visa. Yeah, and there are borders everywhere, you just cross them. But here in Singapore is sometimes challenging, or even when you're in Malaysia or Vietnam or wherever you do it. So sometimes it's just then you get people from that country. Yeah, if you do a hackathon over several days. So I think what I really like about what we achieved here in Singapore is that this is an event where people from many different countries in Asia and from around the world are coming. Let's say there's this great conference in Taiwan, Coast Cup. It's very Taiwan, Chinese-dominated conference, which is also great, right? But here we have a conference that brings together people from across different backgrounds. So, and so the question is how much could we extend that if we make a hackathon? How much longer could we do that and so on? So stretching already a bit. So, let's maybe separate these things. Or if you say, let's try it out, you want to organize the hackathon next year, it'd be cool, okay? So, we can try it out.
Okay, so any other logistic issues that you guys want to bring up so that we can make the next FOSS Asia better? Just want to make sure.
No worries.
I think Mario knows about this, but could you guys have some more vegetarian food the next time around?
More? Okay, sure.
I mean, most of the food was non-veg. Sorry. So.
Got it. Thank you.
It's not always that we do all a lot of vegetarians, but then they come, everything's vegetarian with some pork on top. Yeah, small pork pieces.
But there were vegetarian pigs.
Sometimes it's different what Chinese people think vegetarian or who you talk to. I don't know. We ordered vegetarian, but yeah. Yes. You have some,
It's easy to solve this problem. It's like airline. If you are vegetarian, just say vegetarian.
We did that for lunch, so I think at lunch that wasn't an issue. We had three different options, yeah. But at other points, sometimes we have for example for the kids, there is a special kids IMDA sponsored a small buffet for the kids. And you know, like the caterer just comes, and so there are issues here. So we have to improve, continue improving. So yeah, thank you very much. So. Yeah. There's not just one vegetarian, but there are also vegetarians who don't eat roots and so on. And so it can always, we can always go more into detail. Like there are 20 options when you go on airlines. So we try our best. Like let's improve on that. I think it's already better than last year. The lunch worked out, I think. But like the other things have to work better. We need to make more specific and also reconfirm several times that this is real vegetarian.
Okay, got one more here.
Kim Leung.
Okay, hey. Thanks again for the event. It's my first time here. And I just thought it was a wonderful thing that our open source community is so big. And I actually had a lot of friends come down and they were quite happy about it as well. So thank you. I noticed also some operational challenges. I don't know if it's... I also see some kind of solutions working in place towards that. So I don't know what's going to be like going forward. But I just maybe a good idea to consider having dedicated area leads as well as a dedicated roving leads to go around. So it, because resources are being tight as they are, that way the deployment of resources will be a bit more efficient and communication won't be broken as well, because if the leads, if people responsible for area change, I notice communication sometimes suffers as well because people don't know who to look for and who to ask and things like that.
Hang on, could you give a more specific example? Because the question is also how fast you want the change. Because like I see a lot of, we have different groups.
Yes, yes.
And there was a lot of communication and usually like people came and solved the problem. But like how fast like you can do that?
No, that's, I mean, that's great. I mean, it's most, I was part of the team. I mean, people ask, hey, we're missing adapters and stuff like that. Okay, sure, fine enough. You know, I'm nearby, I just helped out. But I also noticed like, I mean, there was supposed to be some student volunteers, I think, in a specific area. And we went there were nobody, and and things like that happening. I mean, I was originally intended to kind of rove around as well to make sure that, because we have a lot of new volunteers handling equipment, just making sure that, you know, things keep working. But I couldn't do that because end of the day I was like kind of just stuck there. And I suspect maybe for certain dedicated teams as well, like people handling the T-shirts or the people handling getting guests around or just running, making sure that, you know, things get supplied to where they need to go, getting access. Maybe, you know, you could have a dedicated IC to rove around and then do that, as well as people on areas that don't have to move, so that you know, they can get communication stays, as well as they still get the resources they need, like food and drinks and. You know, maybe if the speaker's missing, we'll find a speaker, things like that. Yeah. I don't know if that's specific enough. We could always chat a bit more. I mean,
I think what we need is to reconfirm that speakers are there, which is quite challenging because everyone's from a different country and telephone number, and they might not check. And how can we actually check? And suddenly, like, we are running around and they're already in the room. Yeah.
So this happened a few times, those sort of urgent messages from moderators 15 minutes before a session. Like, help us find this person. And you're at 1 minute before the session, the person just appears again and again. So I don't know.
So, and but you are raising an important point, which is volunteers. I think, like, we should, like, the volunteers this year did a great job. So I want to specifically thank the volunteers for their fantastic work. So I think there was especially one volunteer who you would like to mention, Hong Phuc. You can take the mic.
So we have a group of volunteers come from Dunman High School. Ah, Raphael, you are here. Please come here to the front. Good timing. Okay, thank you so much for all your help. A lot of treating going on over the weekend. And his teacher, Mr. Gee, is not able to make it here this year. And he took over the position of the head of the whole Dunman High School volunteers and coordinated volunteer and help a lot during the event. Thank you so much. How old are you? How old are you? How old are you?
I'm currently 15.
15!
So what we achieved this year is like we had volunteers from last year, training volunteers, new volunteers. So we're on a good path. And how about you join as a volunteer coordinator? No, I'm talking to you. Yeah,
definitely.
Volunteer coordinator next
Jonathan,
year. So thanks for onboarding.
Also our volunteer for the camera crew, right? So want to come back to you that all the challenges that we have. If you look at the program, every day we have about 9 to 10 different jacks. It also a very big challenge for us to make sure that everything runs smoothly. Yeah, and since we are at the content, any one thing that we have that too many checks at Force Asia? Any one thing that the content is too big or too little?
One question at a time. First, raise your hand.
Raise your hand if you think that it's too big.
Okay.
Two things. At least for the technical talks, I believe 20 minutes are a little bit less time for the technical contents to explain. The second, some tracks could have been the full day track. Just a suggestion. I mean, it's okay what we have now, but if we have a full day track, it could have been better. Just a suggestion.
Yeah.
No,
we can just do one track for a month.
Yeah. So I agree. So that's a constraint of the location, and so we are progressing on that. So that's also what we see. Actually, with the tracks, we expanded them a bit to like most sessions were actually 25 minutes, and we gave them half an hour slot. Like, so we told the people 25 minutes, but they actually had half an hour because preparation and something doesn't work. But let's see how we figure that out. So the idea is now with the system that we have in place, the open event system, to give we weren't ready to implement it this year, but to give track organizers more control over their track. Yeah, not just like communicating by email how they want it. It's time consuming, but give them they are track organizers and they can manage their track as they like. So this way it will also become a better solution.
People who live in Singapore, hands up.
Okay, how to increase the number of participants from Singapore next year? That would be my question. There are many people, as you can see, there are too many of us coming outside Singapore. How can we increase the number of participants? We want to grow this event, right?
Okay.
What are we trying to do?
Yeah, I think the key thing here is just about the time and the timing. If you realize now that we are not the location or science center, the time slot given to us, we can try to find a better timing to deconflict from exam period, because this is what happened now. And at the same time, there are also the kind of like a lower secondary or the primary school's holiday, where most Singaporeans actually spend their holidays overseas. So this period, in fact, is not the ideal period. So again, at the beginning of the organizing of Force Asia, I raised this out, knowing the concern. So we'll work with Science Center or perhaps even other location if they give us, so that we can have a much better time window to capture more Singaporean crowd.
But also, Singapore is actually, even though it's a nation, it's actually just a city. So if you organize an event in Pune and like, so many people come over 3 days, maybe you would say, okay, that's great. Because in India, they would come like from different parts of India, maybe, like if you have a big event.
Compare it with India or China, that's a different story.
Okay, good.
Just a bit of feedback about the program. I think the program is really great, but I think one suggestion, if it's possible, can you also put like what's the level of prerequisite knowledge that so we can join like one track? For example, in the first day, the track from Bernie Huang, the Chibitronics, is really good. And I think it's everyone can join that without specific knowledge. But there are certain tracks that once we get in, and then there is so much abbreviation and so much technical terms that we don't understand. And we feel like, oh, I think it's the wrong room because I don't know anything about what he just presented. I want to know more like the basic understanding about the technology. But apparently that's part of like intermediate or like advanced knowledge. So probably like some tracks can be have additional information like this is for beginner, this is for intermediate, and this is for advanced or more like people with technical knowledge about that special subject.
So this is exactly what we're going to have next year. So in our brand new event gate system, when you submit for a talk next year, you will see different level to classify, is it beginner, intermediate, or advanced. So we have the function implement already. We didn't use this for this year, but next year we have it. Okay? Cool. Are we finished? Anything else?
Got one more here. Oh, two more. Hang on.
Just talk about this point, just continue this point. I find out there's one thing a little bit frustrate me. I'm my first time here, join this conference. I find that you see that you have I don't know, maybe 100 talks in 2 days, but I rely on the information online to find out which one is I'm interested. But it's difficult. I find out some of the abstraction as there's a zero statement, there's no statement, and some of them are there's a very long statement. I have no time to read it. I don't want to spend hours time to read it because I want to quickly find the topic that I want. I'm interested. So if you can, have more organized or more well screened for those brief introduction, that would be a lot of help.
I mean, certainly we should curate the summary of the talks.
So to answer the first problem that you mentioned, so let's just say, just some brainstorming. So let's just say that we have a bulletin just on the board every day for you to refer and look at our talks. Will that work for you?
Okay, so speakers, do you hear that? When you submit, please make your abstract really clear and concise so that the attendees can understand easily. That's your job, not us.
So, two more.
Yeah, there was a lot of variation among the different abstracts. So some of them were empty. Some of them just included a description of the bio of the person, but not what the person was going to talk about. So I completely relate to what this gentleman was saying. And then there was another one. There were some of them that were, I think originally they were in different lines, and all the new line characters had been lost. So it was like a block of text, completely unreadable. And I think that those are the ones he's referring to. It was like very difficult to decipher what they were about, especially considering you had to browse the whole list all the time to find what you were looking for. Something that would be really useful would be what is next on the website. Mm-hmm. Because you had to literally browse up and down to find. It took me like an hour and a half or two Friday night and Saturday night each day to shortlist what I was interested in, copy everything over into my own calendar, and then I knew what was going on simultaneously and I could choose on the fly. But if that was on the page, that would have saved me 4 hours of my life.
So we're getting really much into detail already. This is already like several issues that we should post on GitHub. The thing is, so we know these issues, like some of these issues just an import issues. Yeah, HTML. But the question was, should we go with our system and give some pressure to the developers over there? Yeah, and like get some open source project that we use, and we made a lot of progress. So I think with you there are also some design issues. So I will relate them to Victoria, who already volunteered to make a usability kind of track or even like an event or something. Yeah, I mean lots of ideas are there. So so this is on all of us.
Still, yeah? The page was very usable, even from the phone. I mean, that was kind of quite cool.
Yeah.
Another suggestion. I don't know if you have considered using something like Slido, I think is the name of it, that enables audiences to engage on the fly during the talk or at the end of it, like the last 5 minutes. I don't know if there is an open source solution for that, but I've seen it in other events, and it's really cool because you can see like the voting on the fly going on the screen. So you have like five questions made by the speaker. So for instance, for the speakers themselves to get feedback, especially those that were speaking for the first time, that is incredibly useful because it tells them, okay, was my talk clear or something like that? You know, was the level appropriate to the audience and that kind of stuff?
Okay. This is already very, very specific. Let's raise these in a tech discussion or in a discussion about the software project. We have considered a lot. We did what we wanted, what was possible, and also there are considerations like, do we want to run our own server apart on this conference? For example, like our static web app is always a very good backup, because if the server is not working, it doesn't matter. We can still have the static web app. We know, like, I'm a fan of this Chaos Communication Congress, but I don't remember any year where the wiki wasn't down. And aren't these the best hackers and the best devs of the world meeting there? Yeah. So what? Yeah. So that's the thing. So we wanted a web app that's like, you know, can be deployed to GitHub, is static, and it will work. So it is always online. And let's do for next year like a calendar view or something like that as well. Yeah. Whatever we can do. Yeah, and or like some things like that, bookmarks, all these kind of things.
So one final piece of feedback before we wrap.
Thank you.
So just a comment on the logistics discussion just now. I was in the Faraday room yesterday, and the lamp in the projector was long past replacement date. I could hardly read the screen like 1 meter away. So maybe next year, well, at least try to make sure that the projectors, whatever the projection, actually visible from a reasonable distance away.
All right, thank you. So to address this first, I'll bring this point to Science Center because they pay for it. They have to change it. The second part will be, you're right. So let's just say that we'll do kind of like a pre-event check. So indeed, if there is equipment that's not working, then we can get some portable one to kind of replace it, so to speak. Is that okay with you?
Okay. All right. Well, in that case, Fosse 2017 is closed. Thank you very much.
What can happen now?
So now, ish, I don't know what time it is. So pretty much now, if you go one floor down and then across to Newton and up the stairs,